Most people probably think of the LV1 as a live mixing console, but it's actually an absolute workhorse in the studio as well. So today I thought we'd take a look at how to work with the LV1 in the studio and actually treat it as kind of a SSL 4000 console and in conjunction with Reaper. And with the link below, you can download this session file and also the template for Reaper. You can obviously use any DAW you want, but I use Reaper, and it's, as of right now, the DAW that Waves recommend as well. Right, so let's take a look at how to work with all of this. So, first of all, we have 32 input channels with a SSL EV2 plugin on each channel. So, the first 16 with the SSL EV2, then 17 through 32 with just the same plugin, but disengaged just to save on server power. Then on channel 33 through 48, we have the returns coming from the DAW. So anything that you have recorded will show up on these faders. Then channel 49 through 64 are not really used in this case. They are available if needed, but as a starting point, these are not being used. Then we have groups. These are not really being used. Then we have effects, and I just have a reverb that can be used for vocals when recording, and also can be used if needed on stuff coming back from the DAW. Then we have monitors, and these are typically headphones for the musicians playing. All right, so let's go through how you would work with all of this. So let's start with channel one. So obviously, starting point is to set the gain coming in to the console. Then this would go through the SSL plugin. And I like to use some gentle compression and some EQ going into the recording. That way I kind of have a head start when it comes to mixing, because most of the time I know quite well what I'm looking for in each instrument. So some high pass filter I often use, and then EQ and compression to taste. So in this case, these settings will be recorded, so don't go crazy, but some gentle tone shaping. And after you have tailored the sound to your liking, there is a way that the signal is a bit too hot. So then we have this trim knob. And if you have been working on a big analog SSL console, this one is kind of the small fader. So with this, you can trim the signal going into the DAW. If you really want to go crazy with compression, EQ and stuff, and the signal gets a bit hot, you can just turn it down so that you don't clip things going into the recording. All right, so then you just go through all your inputs and just dial in the sound that you want. These faders are for the kind of control room speakers and headphones. So on here you can just dial in things so it sounds the way you want in the control room. And also you can solo things if needed, all without having any effect on the monitor sense. So with monitors, you can just say this is the drummer needs a bit of this and of this, and then the guitar player needs some of this. And then you can just go back to the starting layer, and whatever you want to hear in the control room does not affect the headphones for the musicians. So you dial in everything so it sounds amazing, and then make sure that all the levels going to Reaper are set so that things don't clip. Then you want to listen to the thing you have recorded. So as a starting point, everything coming from Reaper will return on this fader. But in Reaper, you can just choose another output to have it come on another fader on the console. So say you want drums on the first fader, then these are the guitars. Let's send this to fader 2. And then say vocals you want on fader 3. So you just choose these outputs for the vocals. So then you have drums, guitars, vocals on separate faders. So working like this, then you could send this vocal fader to the reverb. And it's the same thing with these returns coming from the DAW, that these faders will only control the volume in the control room. And if you want to adjust any of these levels going to the headphones, you just flip to the monitor sense and make the adjustments needed. And then coming back, these are the control room volumes. So going to the custom layers, here I have channel 1 through 8 and the reverb and also the return 1 and 2. So on this layer, you can do most of the things when it comes to overdubbing and things like that. Here you also have the headphones for the control room, so your Q headphones. And the master is kind of the level to your speakers in the control room. All right, what else? We have mute group 1 will just mute the reverb, and mute group 2 will mute all the inputs. So if you, for instance, have a noisy guitar amp and you just want to listen to what you just recorded, you can just press mute group 2 and then you will mute all of the input channels. So you will only hear what comes from the DAW. So yeah, that's basically it. I've done a few recording sessions like this and it works really, really well. And you can, of course, use any plugins you want. As a starting point, I just used the SSL channel strip, but yeah, you can add anything you want and you can actually then choose, in this case, everything you will put here will be recorded. But if you actually just want these plugins in your headphones when recording, but you want to record the clean sound, you just flip the source to input. So when this source is in input, none of the plugins will be recorded. When it's in pre, all of the plugins will be recorded. All right, that's it. Let me know if you have any questions. Take care.